Part 2, Vitis Project. Creating a Vitis Project. Now that we have our hardware design, let's switch over to Vitis to develop our software. Launch Vitis IDE and create a new application project. When prompted, select the XSA file we just exported from Vivado and create a new platform. For the boot component, choose Zynq MPSoC First Stage Bootloader. This sets up the initial boot process for our Zynq UltraScale Plus device. From provided list for ARM cores, you can see 4 A53 cores and 2 R5 cores are available. Select the first ARM A53 core. It means the final application is targeted to run on the ARM A53-0. Select a name for your project and then press Next. You can see that two options are available: free RTOS and standalone application. For this project, we are going to try a standalone application. For this tutorial, we will use the Hello World template as our starting point. This gives us a basic structure to work with and ensures that our development environment is set up correctly. Exploring created Vitis project. Vitis organizes our work into a hierarchical project structure. At the top level, we have the system project, which combines all the elements needed for our complete embedded system. This includes the bootloader, our application, and the hardware description. Within the system project, we have the platform project, which encapsulates our hardware specification and low-level software. The board support package, or BSP, is another crucial component. It provides the low-level drivers and libraries that our application uses to interact with the hardware. In the BSP settings, we can configure important parameters to change how the application runs. Exploring the Hello World example. In our application project, you'll find the main C file, usually named helloworld.c. This contains a simple main function that prints Hello World to the console. While basic, this example allows us to verify that our entire toolchain is working correctly, from hardware design through to software execution. Building the project. Now, let's build our entire system project. This process involves cross-compiling our application for the ARM Cortex-A53 processors in our Zynq UltraScale Plus device, linking it with the BSP libraries, and generating the final executable ELF file. Go to the debug folder. As you can see, after the build, ELF file created in debug directory. This is the final executable for ARM A53, and it contains our Hello World application. Before we program the FPGA, we need to set the correct boot mode. The ZCU104 has several boot options, controlled by a set of DIP switches on the board. For now, we will use JTAG boot mode, which allows us to program the FPGA directly from Vitis. Booting the Bitstream and application on the FPGA. With our software built, it's time to run it on the actual hardware. First, let's connect our ZCU104 board. We will need to connect the power supply, the JTAG USB connection for programming, and the UART USB connection for console output. To ensure that the board is connected properly, you can open the XSCT console. Then connect and find the connected targets to your computer over JTAG connection. You should be able to see different sections of processing system, like APU and RPU, connected to your computer and ready to be programmed. Using the Launch Hardware feature in Vitis, we will load our Bitstream and application onto the board. You can find downloading process logged in XSCT console. Once programmed, we can see that the LED starts to blink. It means that the PL side is programmed properly, and clock is also provided to the PL side. After that, you should see the Hello World message appear in the Vitis serial terminal or your external terminal program. Seeing this message confirms that our entire development flow is working correctly, from the hardware design in Vivado through to software execution on the ZCU 104.